This video is intended for viewers aged 13 and up. If you are not 13 yet, please leave. Hello everyone, and welcome back to the figure review, baby! Today we're looking at a figure that I have to look at, or else the donation gods will destroy me. Today we're looking at an old favorite who, surprisingly, got a reveal for a re-release today. This month. The Star Wars Black Series Darth Revan. I mean, I was surprised. He really has no potential in, like, new properties, but I guess he had high sales, so we gotta destroy the scalpers. That's a good call, I guess. However, that's because he is a fan favorite character from the old lore. I mean, he's part of a great game, he has a great story, but he looks cool on a shelf, too. However, since many people are probably going to get him for the first time with this mold due to the re-release, I want to review him for new purchasers. And no, this wasn't the planned review for this week. I just got very busy this weekend, like, goodness gracious. So I didn't have time to go forward with that review. To start, the painting and the sculpting on this figure is pretty good. It's nothing too bonkers, but it's all there. However, I have a few issues. To start, let's look at the head. This is probably where some of the most complex sculpting is on this figure. However, I do have some issues. None of those really come from the helmet, though. This thing looks badass. From what I've heard, it's like an ancient Mandalorian helmet. The paint here is pretty good, and I think some of the scratching looks a bit sloppy, but that seems like more of an artistic choice than like an actual QC issue. The QC on the helmet is pretty dang good. However, my issues come in through the hood. It goes too high. A lot of promo shots make it look even worse by having him look down, which gives him an obscenely large forehead. Like, goodness gracious. And that sucks, you know? Also, since it's made of plastic, it's inherently too thick, and paired with the generally small head on the figure, it just looks way too big. It also adds issues in the articulation, but we'll get there later. I honestly love his torso. The kind of bronzish gold looks very nice, at least to me. There's also a lot of nice etching here that is able to emulate the game here that looks very nice and ancient, like it should. The draping of the fake cloth here looks nice. The articulation also hides itself very well through some clever sculpting and design work. The bits of ornamental cloth and metals look very nice here on the lower torso and hips, though it is made of a rubbery plastic. The red skirt strip also looks nice, but it looks decently natural, considering the budget. You know, they probably didn't have a lot. The arms are pretty simple. I like how the arms look like some natural cloth draping on his arms, and how the cloth looks like it bunches up near the gauntlets. I think that's just a smart sculpting design decision. The gauntlets look fine, the paint's nice, but There are some horrible seam lines and nub marks on him that just really detract from the look. Other than that, it seems clean, the hand looks fine. The paint seems, yeah, relatively clean, and they are posed pretty well in the sculpt, you know? If we pull up on his cloth skirt, we get a chance to see his amazingly well-sculpted legs. This may be my favorite part of the body. I love the kind of matte texturing and, like, the subtle way that the cloth folds on itself on the upper legs. I think it looks very nice. And I also love these lower leg armor. It's very nice. It has some very nice subtle scratching on it. The gold, it's different from the gold on the torso, but it's also very nice and appealing. I love all the little sculpted details and painted details that are all over here that really didn't have to be because it's covered by a cloth skirt. The same kind of goes for the feet, which are amazingly well sculpted, painted, and designed. I think they're very cool. And here we get to the cloth. It is very similar in both the waist cape and the main cape, with it being very similarly textured and patterned. And I think there's some very well done ripping detail that doesn't look forced at all. The back under the cape does look a bit simple, but it's fine. It's covered up by the cape most of the time. However, I want to talk about the cloth a bit more. I wish it was able to be used more on Hasbro products. I know that it doesn't last as long, however, it looks a good bit better. Also, it doesn't hamper articulation as much. Again, we'll get to it. And it helps him to be a lot more stable, since the cloth is much lighter than the plastic capes on other figures, which stops him from falling as much. So yeah, overall, the figure looks alright. I mean, it could be a bit better, but it's a serviceable representation of this character. And for many, that's all they may need to get this figure. However, there's a bit more to him than this. For one, he has a couple accessories. Mainly, his two lightsabers. From what I can tell, they're pretty accurate to what's in the game. One is a red lightsaber with a silverish hilt. The hilt is full of cool paint and small details. Both of these lightsabers are kind of the best part of the figure. Then, we also get to the purple blade lightsaber with a gunmetal hilt. Again, very nice painted detail, but I kind of like this one more. It makes sense that this is the one that would be made by Hasbro into an actual physical lightsaber, you know? They both fit into the hands pretty well, as you probably saw earlier. Also, both lightsabers have removable blades so that you can recreate scenes for photography. It's kind of hard to do it, so I'm not gonna do it right now, but it helps it to recreate scenes where he may have unlit lightsabers, I guess, you know? And that's it. No new hands, no new heads, nothing. I think he needed a little bit more, but it's fine. It's a decently cheap figure, but I've seen more from others like Hasbro. Like, man, at least a few hands. Just want a bit more. Maybe the cloth really does take up that much of the budget. From here, we get to the articulation, and look, it's coming back! From what I can tell, his head is on an average Hasbro setup, with a ball joint on a hinge. However, it is limited by this crappy hood. It's only able to go to the left and the right slightly, and it's able to go up and down slightly. As you can tell, the hood really limits movement and stops him from really getting any cool poses. It's just kind of there. That's kind of a problem that I have with the Black Series line, that it kind of prioritizes aesthetics over articulation. As a guy who really likes articulation, it's... Yeah, I mean, it's a fine decision, but it's just not what I would have done, you know? His arms are able to move forward and backwards, but not all the way because of the damn hood. And they're also able to move outwards. They are on kind of a lower arm swivel, which is different. It's different than a bicep swivel. It does a different thing. It's also able to go up a little less than 90 degrees. I wish it had a better arm bit than that. Both hands are able to swivel, but each of them do different things. On the left side, they're able to hinge inward and outward, while on the right side, they're able to do what you actually want to do with a lightsaber hand, hinge up and hinge down, which, whatever. I wish both hands were able to do that, but it's fine. His torso is on a ball joint that lets him move all the way around. His hips are on the typical ball joint setup, which allows them to kick upward that far. Backward about that far. I know it's kind of hard to tell because of the cloth. And they're able to move outward only about that far. Which, again, because of the cloth, the cloth limits it, but not as much as if this was a plastic cloak. There, he would be traffic coned to death, you know? His knees are able to bend a good, decent amount, even with the cloth in the way. He is able to have an upward and downward foot movement, as well as your average ankle rocker. So, yeah, his articulation is decent, but it is limited. However, looking at the legs, his legs would move much less if he had a plastic waist cape. But it is a bit annoying nonetheless. But I think this is just due to how I am. I really like to pose for you, so this is a bit lackluster for me. But yeah, if this is what you want, then sure. Like, I tried to get a dynamic pose here, guys, but that hood is just making it really hard. It does not look cool at all. His head just looks like it's a brick. Looking at this figure, he is a bit shorter than most of the figures in the rest of the line, but I'm sure that's like a canonicity thing, you know? Here he is with some Marvel Legends, some Transformers, some random figures, some Japanese imports, and some Star Wars Black Series figures. In conclusion, I feel conflicted about this figure. There's a lot of cool elements about him, don't get me wrong. And the sheer fact that this character got a figure in the Black Series at all is really freaking cool, especially now that he's getting a real re-release. But I have a lot of frustrations with it. It's got a decent amount of QC issues. I don't think he poses very well, which is a big annoyance for me. And yeah, but I am glad that he exists as a figure. So, if you want him, I guess pre-order him. He's up for pre-order now at wherever you buy figures. I'm not affiliated with anyone. I know who I usually order from, but they aren't sponsoring me, so I'm not gonna name drop them right now. Get this guy if he seems interesting to you. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you're interested in more of this. Next week should be what I wanted to do this week. I'm sorry, this is a low effort review, but I was just very busy this week with E3 and all. Yeah, I'll see you later. Hope you enjoyed my first one, baby.